within this building. The building is a structure within the city. The city is a structure within the province or state. And you can go on and on like this. Structures within structures. And that's why one of the reasons why the word structure is so important for me, because you could think of German semantics as a way of helping us refine our structuring, our way of trying to make sense of things. And we try to make sense by structuring. We can call it abstracting, but when we abstract, we are selecting from the totality of what's given. We are selecting, and in selecting, we have left out. And consciousness of abstracting involves being aware of that selecting that we do, how we select, what we select, and then the fact that we leave out things. So in terms of what we call it, multidimensional structure and analogy, fractal, structure, similarity, big words, but just saying this is like that. This structure is like that structure. Our structure and operations as individuals, since we are part of the universe, is like the structure and operations of many other parts of the universe. So for instance, think of our immune system, a way of fighting off invasion, bacteria. Well, we have armies as a way of fighting off invasion, right? You think of institutions that do what you call the auditing. Well, we can do the same thing when we try to understand ourselves, like self-auditing. So in terms of multidimensional structure and fractals, you can think of any part of the universe as being like other parts of the universe, and that helps us to clarify and understand so many things so easily. And that's one of the things that attracts me to general semantics. It gives me very simple, not simplistic, simple ways of understanding what's going on, both in myself and outside myself. So here's an example of a multidimensional structure. Judgment we make, these are abstractions. We are selecting information from whatever is happening around, and we make judgment, but we don't have all the information, and we're not aware that we don't have all the information most times when we're making a judgment. So we select, and it's being aware that we select what we're talking about, consciousness of abstracting. Right? So listen to this. I was playing. Okay. Now we're talking about breaking things down into smaller, more manageable bits. Here's a bit. One sound, not really one sound, one something. But it's many things going on there. Because if you put a microphone with a spectrogram, an audiogram there, you'll see that it has one sound has many frequencies. So it's a structure, the one sound, right? Now here's another structure. Built up from that one sound. Now how many of you heard? Sound structures, right, that you can hear here. So we have the simple one. What we do generally, we each select from what's going on, we make our own selection, and somebody will say, they will hear through experience and skill and training. They will hear certain rhythms that somebody else don't hear. So if I play and somebody will hear, friend of mine had an anniversary, wedding anniversary, and I was dancing with a lady, and I couldn't dance with this lady. Although I came to the expo in Montreal with the Jamaica Dance Company, so I know a little thing about dancing and rhythms. come down to this lady. So with my training in general semantics, I decided to explore the structure of what was going on. And when I listened carefully, she was dancing to the flute and to the saxophone doing solos, right? Except the saxophone did, so that's what she was doing. And I was dancing to the basic rhythm of the drums and the bass. And so she was doing all these things and I couldn't follow her naturally because I didn't know which one she was going to abstract and do. And so it was, I just let her do her thing. And many times in relationships we have to just let, if we can cope with it, let the other person do their thing. You do your thing and hope that it will work out. Right? But we each select from what's going on. So again, here are the structures from the simple. Once I leave the city, right? But when I come into the city, then I don't know who designed Brooklyn, but somehow I still haven't, I don't come off enough to get enough information to know my way around Brooklyn, but it's really treacherous. And then when I come out of the Grand Central Station, it took me 3 years to figure out which way to go towards to get to the Vanderbilt side. So one time I came out and for the 42nd and I had to go all the way around. And this is what happens when we don't have enough information. And by conscious abstracting is a way that we can attend to things and learn how to learn more about things and situations. Yeah? So see how many structures you can hear in this. And be aware that you're making selections, and it's an example of consciousness of abstracting, because as I mentioned in the paper, the principles of general semantics are things we can do, actions we can take, and they're both, they can think of them as both verbs and adverbs, adverbs in terms of modifying the way we do usually do things. Right? modifying and refining the way we usually think and do things. Right? So here it goes.
Thank you.
something happens. The drum at certain rhythms vibrate a certain way. And it's not just the skin. The skin vibrates when I play, right? It's doing that. But there's some rhythms that somehow the whole drum starts to vibrate. And the vibration doesn't feel like it stopped there. It feels so powerful sometimes that I have to stop because I get the feeling that it could damage something. Maybe just imagination, but I really have to stop because it feels like it's a wave going out into the universe. And when that happens, it doesn't stay for long because my awareness of it, here did the observer observe the interaction, my awareness of it sometimes stops it because my awareness of it plays different. I play differently and it stops.